In the name of Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. We say all together, you are so lovely. You are so lovely, everyone. You are so lovely. It is so privileged to celebrate together with you in the presence of our Lord through the Word of God and through the Holy Sacrament. Today is the third Sunday of Lent. We are in the center of the Lent. How important, why, what we are doing now, especially during the Lent, for what? As we know very well, for just the one thing. This one thing is very important, to believe. Jesus had a passion for us. Jesus died on the cross for us. Jesus rose again, resurrection for us. This is more important than other things. The resurrection is for human life. It's so important. As we know very well, human has a body and a soul. This is very important because we cannot follow just material things. You cannot say, I love my wife, just the body. I love my husband, my partner, body. No. When you say, I love you, means I love you totally, all body, soul, with the spirit which God breathed you. So how beautiful. But we know very well, especially in this pandemic season, time, many people, unfortunately, are very sad because they are seeing material things, not spiritual, more important things God gave us in our inner life. Today, we can see some gesture or some scene of Jesus is very strange in temple. First time in the Holy Gospels mentioned about Jesus was really angry. So somebody would say, why Jesus is as a son of a man and a real prophet, a real king, real, you know, the priest, why he was so angry? This is a very important interpretation, especially not because God has not been angry, but also God is important to show us, especially His mercy and His love and His forgiveness. But if something is wrong, something is not good, what God has established, obviously, that is not good. Injustice, we say. When Jewish people believed or had a beautiful devotion into the temple, the meaning of a temple is for Jewish people just one word, the sacrifice. The sacrifice for their sins. For this reason, Jewish people was very keen with just the material, the building, the temple. For this reason, probably, they had more tempted or temptation by, you know, the evil spirit to have a ritual or action with the material things. In the eyes of Jesus Christ, the temple was not good because Jesus, all the three different Holy Gospel, Matthew, Mark, and Luke, mentioned about this one. The temple, the house of my Father, should be the prayer of a house, the house of a prayer. I mean, where we can meet and speak to our God, the God, the Father. But what happened? It was a market. So many things cheated or not good anyway. For this reason, Jesus stop doing this one. Don't follow this material things more. But more important, you believe your heart. In the New Testament, St. Paul said, in fact, our body, where Holy Spirit is living. So, this body is the temple of a Holy Spirit. So how gracious, how important to have the Sunday worship, the Mass, to listen to the Word of God. And through the Word of God, we have already the Holy Spirit in our heart. And also, as a material things, we will have a Holy Communion. Through the Holy Communion, we have a real body and a real blood of Jesus Christ. So all these things is completely soul and bodies of a human, completely by the Spirit of God. This is an excellent and more beautiful gift which comes from God. As a first reading, we know very well, it's very important and remember about Jesus' life through the Moses. Moses and mentioned about God's word. I am the Lord your God, who brought you out of the land of Egypt, out of the house of slavery. Jesus came to our life. Jesus saved us from the sins. We don't need to offer now more cattle or sheep or pigeons and cut, you know, this animal and spell or, you know, scatter the all over the world, you know, the blood as a symbol of a sacrifice. We don't need to do more, never ever, because we have a Jesus Christ who gave us his blood for the human's sin. And then Jesus was said, remember, do it, this one, and remember me. What? We remember Jesus died. Jesus rose again, resurrection. That is our life. And also, what scriptures especially, you know, give us today. So this temple is no more the temple of, you know, the what you see, the material things. The temple of God is Jesus' body, which enter in your body. So you are the temple of God, the temple of the Holy Spirit. This is so beautiful. How many times, for example, me as a first person, I really enjoyed to listen and read this second, you know, the readings, First Corinthians. While the Jews demand miracles, if you like to follow miracles, you are Jews, Jewish people. And the Greeks look for wisdom. If you follow just the intelligent, a beautiful, you know, the speaker, or beautiful your thought, or intelligent, etc. You are Greeks. Here are we preaching a crucified Christ. We don't follow miracle. We don't follow, you know, the thought or intelligent or, you know, the wisdom, human's wisdom. I have a lot of a degree, a university, academy, etc. But also, we follow, we proclaim Jesus crucified. For this reason, we are lovely children of God. In the name of St. Hugh and St. James, with St. John Bosco. My dear brothers and sisters, at this time, we need to always proclaim Jesus crucified, who died for us, who rose again as a resurrection from the dead for all humanity. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.